Math is awesome. As a math teacher, you know this for a fact. Then why do your students describe your favorite subject as hard or boring? In this video, I'll show you how you can bring some interactivity to different math topics. There are tons of games that can help students practice math. I sorted out a few amazing apps and websites. The first one is BuzzMath. BuzzMath is a website where your students can practice. Kids are challenged to save BuzzCity from math ignorance. BuzzMath has a list of topics and core-aligned interactive quiz-like lessons. The second app is GeoPort. GeoPort is a tool for exploring a variety of mathematical topics introduced in the elementary and middle grades. Learners must stretch bands around the pegs to form line segments and polygons to learn about area, angles, fractions, and more. It's an open-ended educational tool, ideal for elementary classrooms and other learning environments that use iPads. You can also use book widgets for teaching math. The youngest math pupils start by learning simple additions and subtractions, then move on to multiplication and division. The arithmetic widget lets them solve simple arithmetic problems, adapted to their level. A lot in math involves functions. Knowing what these functions look like and how they change when their parameters change is key to understanding them. Creating your own interactive plot with the Active Plot widget is easy. Simply enter the functions you want your students to learn about and let them play with the parameters. Students can also enter their own functions or using drawing tools to annotate the plot. The Crossword widget is a fun way to practice math terminology and definitions. You enter a definition and students fill in the words. Formulas and definitions need to be memorized, and the Flashcard widget is a fun way to do so. For example, you can put pictures of geometrical shapes on one side and enter the formula to compute their area on the other side. Another fun way to practice math is by turning it into a pair matching game where students have to find matching cards. You can create card pairs for terms and their definitions, equations and their answers. The younger pupils can play pair matching games to learn fractions. When they're done studying math, the time has come to test their knowledge. The quiz widget lets you do just that. Besides multiple choice questions, the quiz widget also offers question types specifically tailored to math. For example, students can answer questions with fractions, mixed numbers, or exponents. Quizzes are automatically graded. When your students submit their answer to you, both widgets will automatically assign a score, so you don't have to check the answer yourself. So, that was it for today. I hope I've inspired you to teach more interactively. Check out the blog for more ideas. Hope to see you next week.